Secure and easy remote access to Home Assistant and respectively your smart home is becoming one of the most important tasks these days that you can do, as it is an enabler for so many things, and it will not matter are your home or not, you still have full control of your house. Here is one free and fast way to accomplish that Home Assistant remote access. This time it is done by using Tor. More specifically, using the Tor add-on that is available as one-click install in the Home Assistant add-on store. This Tor add-on makes it possible to access your Home Assistant instance remotely as an Onion site without the need to open firewall ports or configure SSL certificates, but still having a secure HTTPS connection. Tor is an acronym that stands for the Onion Router. The Onion Router is a pretty interesting thing. When you browse the internet, your connection goes through various servers, right? Well, Tor takes that to a whole new level. Using Tor, your internet traffic bounces around a bunch of different volunteer-operated servers worldwide. It is like a virtual maze for your data. Each server in this Tor network only knows the previous and next server in the chain, so it is hard for anyone to trace your online activities back to you. One cool thing about Tor is that it helps protect your privacy, since your data is constantly being shuffled around. It is tough for anyone, including governments, to figure out what we are doing online. That can be really useful if you want to keep your browsing habits private, or if you are in a country with strict internet censorship, or you just want to access your Home Assistant and respectively your smart home from anywhere in a secure and anonymous way. That is because Tor is not all about anonymity and privacy. It also allows you to access websites that are hidden in the depths of the internet, the so-called Onion sites. But hey, it is not all rainbows and unicorns with Tor. Because your data bouncing around so much, your connection speed can be slower compared to the regular browsing. Anyways, here is how I managed to install the Tor add-on and how I enabled the Home Assistant remote access using Tor. Just a quick side note, I'm using some acronyms and abbreviations that may not sound very clear for you. To help you further with that, I created a smart home glossary that is full of simple and useful explanation, and it is coming as one PDF file that can be used anywhere online or offline. On top, it is totally free and you can instantly download it from my website automatelike.pro/glossary. Tor add-on is installed, but it needs a bit of configuration before I can start it. Here is an example configuration that I use. Setting the SOX option to true opens port 9050 to listen for connections from SOX speaking applications. Enabling this feature allows you to use other applications on your network to use the Tor network. If you need that and you know what are you doing, set it to true. Otherwise, leave it false. Next, setting the stealth option to true will make your traffic to and from your Home Assistant instance over Tor to be hidden even from other nodes on the Tor network, which generally is a good thing as it improves the security even more. But at the same time, it adds another layer of complexity as you will be required to make some changes and configurations on the Tor clients that you use later, and not every Tor client is supporting that. I'll set this option to false for this demo. But if I had something very important in my Home Assistant, I was going to try to turn it on. So, decide for yourself, do you need that enabled or not? If you decide to enable it after all, you can find more information in the documentation. Generally, you have to also include some client names and to add an authentication cookie in your Tor client configuration, again, if that is supported. A next and final configuration are the ports, where you can describe which ports and which IPs will be published via a Tor online service, and you can list multiple hosts and ports, but I'll limit myself only to the IP of my Home Assistant and the default Home Assistant port. Finally, I'll save the changes and I'll start the Home Assistant Tor add-on. Then I'll open the logs tab to see if everything is okay And here I should also see my .onion address. Then I can try to open this address using a Tor client. These Tor clients are like browsers, but specially designed for the Tor network, and they're available for all major operating systems and devices. I will try the official Tor browser that can be started on Windows, Linux, Mac, and Android. For iOS, I tried the .onion browser, and it worked just fine. These Tor clients are installed as usual, and they're looking as normal browsers, but they can open .onion addresses. So, if I paste mine, I would see my Home Assistant opened and ready to be used. It is a good idea not to share your .onion address with anyone, and to enable two-form factor authentication just to be on the safe side. If you reach this point, congratulations! As a reward, I want to invite you to my Home Assistant webinar, where I'll talk about the different official Home Assistant installation types, plus one secret way to run Home Assistant on a PC in under 5 minutes. The webinar is all free, and you can reserve your seat right now on my website, automatelike.pro/webinar. Thanks for watching, I'm Kirill, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!